quote.
How about that?
Are you surprised Doc said this?
No, because Doc Rivers is probably the smartest PR coach in the league. He's great when it comes to public relations. He's smart. So I get it, defending your player. Whether or not this was really a shot at Kawhi or not, it's construed that way. Right. And you got to back your player. So Doc was right. He was smart to do that. Mm-hmm. However, there's two problems with it. One, it really was not a shot at LeBron. It was a shot at the Lakers front office and coaching staff, because you're really giving LeBron the ultimate compliment for a player. You're saying he runs the franchise.
That's
He's the boss, okay. Right? LeBron says, go get AD, you go get AD. Okay. LeBron says, I want to load manage, he loads manage. I want to play, he plays. And that's a great compliment for any player to have that much power, but especially when your team that you put together, kind of, that's what Doc's saying, is 24-4. So I think it's really, he meant it as a shot at LeBron, but it's really a compliment. That's the first problem. The second one is that Doc's being a little bit hypocritical, because we know that the only reason, I don't remember Doc doing load management with Chris Paul, with Blake Griffin, with Kevin Garnett, and especially Chris and Blake, who were really injury prone. And if anybody could have used load management, it would have been those guys. We know that everyone around the league is saying, Kawhi was telling teams or the Clippers, I'm giving you about 65 games and when he was recruited. And the Clippers are right. I would do it. And if Kawhi wants to load manage,
everybody would
do it. Right. But I'm just saying, he's calling out LeBron when your team is doing the exact same thing. Whatever Kawhi says, because if Kawhi comes back after Christmas and says, you know what, I want to play back-to-backs, he's playing back-to-back. So that's what Doc said, I get it, but it doesn't stand up to scrutiny.
Hold on. He said LeBron is running your franchise. Why did the Clippers go get Paul George? Who said go get Paul George?
Good point.
Because Sam Presti, who was the general manager at the time of the OKC Thunder, on Woj podcast, said he got a call from Paul George's agent, said he and Kawhi had been talking for several weeks, over a month, and said they would like to play together, preferably in L.A. For the Clippers. Now, if it's a lie, Sam Presti lying. I tend to believe Sam Presti. Don't you, Skip? Mm. He seems like an honorable man. Any man that wear glasses, he won't lie to you. Mm. So I believe won't say.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, a man that wear glasses won't lie.
Wait, you shattered that.
Hold on. But I take these glasses off.
I'm about to tell him.
I agree. And that's what I told. I told Skip the very same thing. Now, because when Paul Pierce, the first year with the Big Three, Paul Pierce played 80 games, 81 games, 71, 80. Now, there's only 82 games, so I'm trying to figure where the load management is. Ray Allen played 73, 79, 80, and 80. Where's the load management? Blake Griffin and Chris Paul, where's the load? Skip, where is that? Dog, you thought you always did this. Stop it.
You didn't say he always did.
Yes, he did.
That's our philosophy.
That's always been our philosophy.
He didn't say always.
He said it's now our philosophy. It's our since July 7th, whatever the date was.
Is it your philosophy with Sweet Lou? Montrez, or is your philosophy with Kawhi?
Even Paul George, hadn't he played every game? He's about to pass Kawhi in short order.
That's interesting.
Skip,
I have no problem. You understand that superstars carry a lot of weight in the NBA, and they normally swing the pendulum of power. That's why guys can say, when a superstar guy says, I want out, you end up moving him, because he's going to make it very uncomfortable for you. And that's why he says, well, I want you to try to go get this guy. Because guess what happens? If Giannis says, I want to leave, if he tells Budenholzer, you know what? I just want to play about 78 games a year. He goes on the free agent market. Who's going to tell him, nah, you got to play all 82?
Okay. So what?
But don't make it seem like that's your philosophy. That's the superstar player's philosophy.
That's what he accepted from Kawhi, because anybody would.
Why would he say LeBron is running the Lakers when, to a large degree, Kawhi is running the Clippers?
That's all I'm saying.
Did Kawhi say go get Mo Harkless? Did he say go get Magruder?
No, he didn't. But
LeBron does do that for the Lakers.
Did he say go get Paul George?
24-4?
Did he say
go get Paul George?
I agree. It's 24-4.
Did he say go get Paul George? Yes or no?
I already told you, LeBron has far more power within the Laker organization than Kawhi wants to have within the Clippers. All Kawhi wants to do is manage himself. Did he obviously say, I got to have Paul George? Well, obviously he's not going to go by himself to the Clippers.
Why not?
What do you mean, why not?
Why not?
He needs
LeBron wouldn't do it.
He did. Huh? Remember, he knew
they was getting somebody, though.
He went by himself,
and he thought they might get Paul George.
Yeah. He thought they were going to get Jimmy Butler. He thought they were going to get a whole bunch of people. They all said no to it, including Kawhi Leonard.
So if you don't mind me asking, what Kawhi uncle doing?
What's his uncle doing? Yeah. Who cares?
Oh, he cares. Yeah. Oh, that ain't none of my business. I don't even know why I brought that up, Chris. You know what I should keep saying?
Okay. So here's what happened. This season has quickly boiled down to LeBron versus Kawhi or Kawhi versus LeBron, however you want to look at it, one way or the other. And they have been going at each other sort of between the lines from the start of this year. And because nobody has taken off in the West except these two teams. And by the way, the Clippers, they're playing pretty well. They're playing at a high level. Yeah. Can't wait for Christmas Day.
Me either.
But again, the season, quote unquote, doesn't even start until Christmas Day. But you look around the West and all those other teams I thought were going to be pretty to very good. Not so far. Maybe they'll all take off later. I still think Houston has a shot to be very good. But they're so far so pretty good with Houston. But the point is, it's LeBron. It seems like on a nightly basis, he is pointedly saying, when LeBron is healthy, LeBron plays. And how is Doc going to interpret that? It's a shot at Kawhi Leonard.
They ask him about him. They ask him about Low Manny. But what's he supposed to say? He can't worry about
what
somebody else
is doing.
LeBron, though, you got to give him this, Skip. He rarely takes shots at other players, particularly other stars.
Okay.
Right?
But so it I don't seems know if it was a to LeBron or... that starting on opening night against the Clippers, what commercial dropped, what shoe dropped on that night? You can dismiss the shoe all you want, but it was a shot from Kawhi at LeBron, and he took it personally. And now he's firing back, I'm going to play every game because he knows that plays well. He's playing to the crowd that wants to say, why are you doing this, Kawhi? Well, Kawhi's only been doing this since his rookie year in San Antonio. I don't play back. He's been doing it. He load managed right out of college. It's who he is. And I got to tell you, this is the tortoise or hare argument here because I'm going to bet on the tortoise on the long term because LeBron can run and play all these minutes. LeBron hasn't missed a game yet. 28 for 28.
Chris, I know you've been covering the game two decades.
25 years.
25 years? How many games did Michael Jordan load manage? What about Kobe?
Never.
What about Kobe?
Never.
Well, Karl Malone load managed?
Never.
Bird load managed?
Yeah. Well, Kobe should have load managed a little more before his last three.
No, because Skip, when you play at that level, Skip, you don't know when your last game is.
Okay.
You go out there and you lay it all on the line.
Okay.
And
all I'm saying is LeBron James is playing a dangerous game. I've told both of you this from the start. He's averaging 35 minutes a night. That's fifth most in the whole league in year 17.
That's the thing. It's scary. His career.
It's scary.
If there was no Kawhi and no load management, would we be saying no? I think we'd be saying LeBron's actually dialed it down. He's only playing 34 minutes a night.
That's right.
Well, lowest in the league. That's
but lowest
high.
For him. We just can't. I said it before. We can't let Kawhi's load management skew our view of everything else.
Okay. Not mine.
Because then everybody, now you know, they have to win it. Kawhi better win it. That's the way you justify this, right?
Well, I might say LeBron better win it. You got to justify getting
AD. He didn't get hurt.
So let me get it straight. So we're going to take 1 year, and we're going to disregard the other 50 NBA champions. We're going to take Kawhi's 1 year of load management, and we're going to disregard the Bulls' 6 titles. We're going to disregard the Lakers' 15 titles and the Celtics.
It's not 1 year of load management. I told you, he's been doing this. You just didn't notice. He was doing it all through his San Antonio years.
But
he was the MVP of a finals.
Yes.
And then he was the MVP of last year's finals,
In San Antonio, they thought he was soft because he wouldn't play through any little nick.
Okay,
ailment,
he was load managing on his own. He just said, I'm not going to play. Right.
Did it bother you then, though?
Well,
here's the worst part of it. If they do win it, if the Clippers win it, he plays 60 games, they win it. It's going to trickle out throughout the league. Then Harden might be load management. Luka might start load management. And that's a problem. If all the superstars start playing 60 to 65 games,
if I was the owner, you know what I'd do? I'd say I'm going to start load managing some of these contracts.
Yeah, I was going to say,
I'm going to load manage those. Because I'm getting paid on a game basis. I'm a low D contract.
They don't load manage in football. They shouldn't be load managing in basketball.
But you can't, the game's me too.
I've seen it trickle all over the place. Westbrook's been taking games off.
But not, it's one thing to play 74 games, yeah, and that's fine.
Yeah.
But 60? Take off a quarter of the season? Right. That's a quarter of the season. Yeah.
No, you ain't low managing football. The game's me too much. You only got 16.
Yeah.
That'd be like missing four games.
You bring up a good point, though, that if you got to win it or else, and if it affects everyone else moving forward, it
could be a bad
and superstar. I mean, you, a quarterback can't low manage. You're not winning no game without Tom Brady. You're not, you're not winning no game with without Dak.
All right, we're going to have Chris.
I just want to say this.
What?
One last thing. Thank you, Doc.
Thank you.
There was no hypocrisy there. There was no hypocrisy there.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You can't even say
he just wanted to take a shot.
Skip likes it. Okay, we're gonna actually put a grade on LeBron's.